When we downloaded Linux Mint, one of the things we did was we chose a desktop, either Cinnamon, KDE, Mate, or XFCE, and we chose Mate. We can have more than one desktop on our system at the same time, then we can try them out and see which one we like best. I intentionally put this video after the backup video because if for some reason this does not work out or crashes your computer, you'll be able to restore back to where we took the backup a few videos back. To download the Cinnamon desktop, I'm going to Menu, Software Manager, and up in the search tool, I will type in Cinnamon. And right at the top, we see the Cinnamon desktop. I will click to install the Cinnamon desktop. We've installed the Cinnamon desktop. I'll close this, and before we go over to that, I want to do a few screen prints so that we can compare the screens. I'll open up the Firefox browser, pressing print screen. We will save this as Firefox and we'll save it on the desktop. Let's try in the Office, LibreOffice Calc. And I will do a print screen here. We will call this Calc and save this on the desktop. And I'll do one more. We'll go into Sound and Video Brazero and print screen here. Now I will log out and log back in on the Cinnamon desktop. I'm clicking on this little mark right next to the flag and then selecting Cinnamon. From there, I'm typing in my password. And I want this just for this session. I've logged in to the Cinnamon desktop and the first thing I want to do is check for any updates. Our system is up to date, that's good. Now let's change the background to something better than this black background. I'll right click, change desktop background, and it's bringing us to the Linux Mint, so we can put in the Linux Mint 17.2. It also has some pictures from previous versions of Linux. There's Maya, there's Olivia, or I can go right down to my own pictures. I'm going to stick with the Linux Mint 17.2. Coming down to the main menu here, we see that it's similar to what we had on the Mate menu, just a little different. The graphics are a little different and the menu itself looks a little different. I wanted to bring up the Firefox browser. And then I'm going to compare it with the picture that we took on the Mate system. And I'm looking mostly at the menu toolbars up here at the top. We see on the Mate system, we have a little arrow down in the corner and then the File, Edit, View menu. Up here, we do not have that arrow down and our menu bar pops out a little bit with those lines above and below. Other than that, it looks pretty much the same. Let's try the LibreOffice Calc. Compared to the picture, same thing. We don't have the arrow in the corner, and our menu bar kind of stands out a little more. But other than that, it's pretty much the same. Let's try Brazero. going into sound and video, Brazero, and bringing up our picture. Here again, we see our menu bar is a little more plain on the Mate version of Linux. And the buttons look a little different too. And the graphics on the buttons, here we've got a single note, there we've got two notes. On our disk, we've got a little page and a film. They're on the right-hand side. On the Mate version, they're on the left-hand side. But things are pretty much the same. There is one difference that I want to point out. Going into administration, down at the bottom here, users and groups, we've got two of them. One is for the Mate version and the other is for the Cinnamon version. Let's click on this top one here. In this one, when we click the Add button, we can add a new user, but this does not allow us to encrypt the user like we did with Jack. This is the Cinnamon version of users and groups. The reason we know that is because, let me go back to administration, users and groups, clicking on the bottom one. This is the version that we use to create Jack and Jill. If we click on Add User, this allows us to encrypt a home folder. What I'm showing here is when we add extra desktops, sometimes it also brings in extra programs that do the same thing. And in this case, the user setting, one for Cinnamon and one for Mate. Now I want to bring in a couple more desktops. I'm going to go into the Software Center and I want to type in XFCE, and I'll download the XFCE desktop. And I'm also going to look for, let's go back to categories, the KDE desktop. And I want to bring in the complete KDE desktop, so I'll bring in KDE full and install. So we've installed the full KDE. I'm going to close this. I'm going to check for updates. We're all up to date. That's good. I want to try opening LibreOffice. We'll do Calc. And we have a problem getting into LibreOffice Calc. I looked into this a little further, and the problem is when it did the update, the ownership changed to the root user and not the Michael root user. So what I need to do is go into System Tools, Console, that's the same thing as a terminal. I'll make this a little larger. And we need to change the ownership from the root user to Michael. To do that, I'll type in sudo for superuser do. Chown, or change owner to Michael, and that will be for the directory found in home michael.config.libreoffice, and then we want to dash r, so this will work not only for this directory but any directory created underneath this directory. It's asking for the password. Now we also want to do this for Jill. Jill might have the same problems, so I will do the same thing for Jill. Change the owner to Jill, where in the home file, then we go into Jill's home file, .config, LibreOffice, and we'll make this dash capital R. We should be all set. Let me close this and try and go into Office, LibreOffice Calc. And now we can get in. We did add the two more desktops. I'm going to leave those for you to try them on your own if you like. In the next video, we're going to look at how to remove Linux from the operating system and keep Windows still on that system. If you like these videos, please tell a friend.